Hi everyone, in this video I'll be showing you how to implement auto increment of a ID of a column in MySQL using Node.js. So let's get started. So for this we will be needing two libraries, one is Express and another one is MySQL. So just go to your folder in terminal of Visual Studio Code and type npm space I space Express and MySQL and just hit enter. Just wait till the download gets completed. Once the download is complete, just go to your folder and just create a new file. I will name it as main.js and hit enter. And let me just close this now. So as usual, we will be first importing the libraries. So it's going to be var express equal to require express. And let me just now copy this and paste it and replace express with MySQL and MySQL here as well. And next thing we will be like declaring our app. So var app equal to express, and also we will be using express.json because we will be passing data in the form of JSON. So it's going to be app.use express.json. All right, so now we are done with our import, and next thing we need to create our connection variable. So it's going to be const. Let me name it as con equal to MySQL. So you need to use this particular variable name over here, dot create connection, open a circular bracket and curly bracket, and within this we need to specify host, user, password and database names. So let me begin with the host. So it's host, and since I'm using MySQL locally, it's going to be localhost over here and put a comma, and next one is user. So you need to specify the username over here. For me the username is root, and this username directly corresponds to the username that you are having in your MySQL. So by default many will be having root, but it really depends on the user. All right, so you need to be specific with your username. And next thing is the password. So this also changes from person to person. Let me just enter my password as well. Yeah, that's fine. And next thing is going to be the database. So we need to specify only a existing database, all right? So for this purpose, let me go to my MySQL workbench. I'm going to use this particular database, NewDB. So let me just now copy this and let me just create this database as well. Yeah, database has been created. So if I just now refresh it, yeah, NewDB is over here. So let me just pass the name over here. So this is fine. We are done with our connection variable. And next thing, we need to connect with the help of this connection variable. So it's going to be con.connect. We'll be having this connect function. And here we will be having a callback function. So it's going to be error. So in case of any error in our connection, this will be like able to catch that error. So it's going to be if any error, let's just console.log that particular error, and in the else block we will be just having a console.log as connected like that. So this is now fine for the basic stuff, and let me just now save it and run it at first just to verify if it's working fine or not. So for running it, it's going to be node your .js file name, which is main in my case. So it's main.js. Yeah, so here you can see I'm getting connected, which means that there isn't any error over here. So now let me just stop it. So it's Control plus C to stop. So once you are done with the connection variable, I'll be showing you how to implement the post operation, because we need post operation to basically implement auto increment. All right, so I'll just come down off this connect, and it's going to be app dot the post function. All right, so this app basically corresponds to the variable name that we are having over here, and here we need to specify the path. So it's going to be slash post. So this slash post will be coming over here, all right, in this URL in postman. And next thing is just a callback function. So it's going to be request comma response and an arrow function over here. And in my table, I am having three columns, all right. One is of type int, ID, name and mark. So I'm just going to auto increment this particular ID column, all right. So I will be getting the value of name and this mark column from the postman as a request payload. So for that, we will be using the request body over here. So it's going to be const name equal to request dot body dot name. Let me just now copy this. Just paste it. I will just put mark over here, and it's going to be mark over here as well. So we will be using request.params if you are getting any value from the parameter. Since I'm getting the value from a postman request body, alright, I'm using request body over there as well. And next thing, we'll write the simple SQL query for inserting value. This is like so common. So it's going to be our connection variable, which is con in this case, is going to be con dot query function, alright. Query, and next thing is going to be insert into table name. So my table name over here is my table itself. So this particular my table is present inside this database that you have specified over here. So be careful in that. And it's going to be into the table name. And next you need to specify the column names that you're going to add. So here I'm going to insert, for as I told you earlier, mark and name column. All right. So I will just put name first, and I will just put comma and a mark, and it's going to be values. And after that, just put question mark, comma, question mark, and just close the circular bracket and just come out of this single quote, all right. And it's going to be square bracket, and within that, just pass name, comma, mark, all right. So this question mark over here will be replaced by this name value, and this question mark will be replaced by mark value. So which means that this name is going to get inserted in name column, this value over here will be inserted in the mark column. I hope that made sense. Just a simple SQL query, all right. And once you're done with this particular step, we will be having another callback function, which basically has error, comma, result, and another arrow function over here. So it's pretty much a straightforward post operation. Only the major change for auto increment will take place in the SQL query while creating the table, all right. So only this line changes, I guess, because we will be having values. Name equal to question mark, mark equal to question mark, but here we will be having the name and mark column names coming near the table name. All right, so I think these are some of the changes or differences between normal post and auto increment post operation. All right, so let me just now copy this and paste it. So if you're having any error, I'm consoling it, and if I don't have any error, let me just have it as posted, and I will send this as a response. Where I'm going to console, I'll just send response.send, and this response will be coming over here, all right, as a message in this response area. So I think we are now good with our post function. So before going into that, I will show you that what are the changes that we need to do when creating the table, all right. So I think we have already created the new DB database. So before creating the table, all right, you need to add primary key and auto increment constraint to your ID, all right. So I'll just come here, just add some space after the data type, and it's going to be primary key, and you need to specify auto underscore increment. It's not auto space increment, it's auto underscore increment. So you need to be really careful. You need to just add these two properties, and you need to just run this, all right. Yeah, so I'm getting a green mark, so this is fine. And let's suppose say that you have forgotten to add both these constraints. So in that case, you need to use the alter table, all right. I'll just show you a demo what that command looks like. It's going to be alter table, your table name. So it is my table in my case, and you will be using the modify clause, all right. Modify the column that you need to add auto increment. So you don't just copy this, basically. It's going to be the same thing. Modify, and just I'll put it here. ID, the column name, the data type, you need to have primary key constraint, and you need to just put auto increment. So this basically converts a normal column present in a table to an auto increment primary key column. Like, it basically adds these properties, okay. In case if you have forgotten to add it when you're creating a table, you can later add this using this particular alter table modify command, okay. So let me just now remove this, and if I just now go and see the description of my table, so here you can see I'm having primary key constraint and auto increment constraint for the column ID, so which makes perfect sense, I guess. So now let me just go and complete the code over here, all right. Yeah, so we are done with the post operation over here. The final thing, we have to start our server, make it listen. So for that, it's going to be app.listen. I'm going to run it on port 3000, and it's also going to have a callback function. So let me just again go and copy this and paste it. I'll just have it as on port 3000. Yeah, that's fine, I guess. So let me just now save it, and I'll go to node, my file name .js, and hit enter. So it's saying on port 3000 and connected, which means that there isn't error so far in our code. So now let's go to Postman. All right. So first important thing that you need to know is you need to just change this operation to post. All right. Really important thing. Change it to post, and you need to type this out: http://localhost:3000/, and you need to add this particular path after that. It's going to be this path that you have specified over here. For me, I've entered post, so you need to just paste it over here. So it's /post, all right. So after doing this, you'll be having the body as none. So you need to change it to raw, and you need to change this to JSON, all right. I think by default it will be in text or some other format. You need to just change it to JSON. And here I am having So this is a particular JSON structure. I'm having name and mark as the value. I think mark, there shouldn't be any double quotes for mark, because mark is of type int. Only type varchar or string should be enclosed within double quotes. I will just have some name, meaningful name. Let me go with ABC. So if I just now send it, we need to have our ID value automatically incremented in the table, because ID is auto incremented. So we need to just add the values for name and mark column. I hope that made sense. So if I just now send this, so here you can see I am getting posted, which means that there isn't any error in our app.post function. So if I just now go to my MySQL workbench, and if I just do select, so here you can see I'm getting the ID value as 1. So if I just now again go to my Postman, and this time I will go with A, and I will just change it to 10, and if I just now send it, I'm getting posted again. And if I just now again select asterisk from my table, I'll be having a row with ID 2, and the values are also getting inserted. So which means that our auto increment is perfectly working. So here is the main change, all right. And you have to also make this change over here as well. So I hope you have found this video useful. I have also done many other videos in put, post, delete, in MySQL using Node.js, as well as MongoDB, as well as React.js, C, C++, Java, Python. So do check other videos of my channel. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.